in tenfold cross validation, we won't divide data in the form of training data and testing data. What we will do is we will divide the data into 10 parts. They are called as folds. We will take first fold as testing data and remaining 9 folds as training data, and we will train the model with 1 testing data and remaining 9 training data. Yes, we will get some accuracy score for that first instance. For second time also, we will take second fold. Here see, second fold as testing data and remaining 9 folds as rain fold as training data in 10 fold cross validation. Okay, na? For the next time, we will take third as testing data and remaining 9 as training data, and we will train the model, we will test the model, and we will get some accuracy. This can be done until 10 folds has been done, and the mean of the 10 accuracies is called as accuracy calculation. Okay, na? Accuracy calculation. This is what the algorithm of 10 fold cross validation. After 10 fold cross validation, what we are doing is we are here we are separating the independent variables and dependent variables. Let us see, this is our data set. Now, what are independent variables and what are dependent variables? Our agenda is to find whether the cancer is in malignant stage or Belgian stage. For that, these nine are the dependent variables. This is independent variable. Now I am separating them. See, until last one, they are independent variables. Last one is dependent variable. That is named as X, that is named as Y. Okay, na? Now, after separating the independent variables and dependent variables, now I am performing label encoding. What is the purpose of label encoding? See here, for the last column, I am having 2 and 4 integers. That might be difficult for prediction. Now I am going to convert that as 2 as 0, 4 as 1. So to convert the numbers into binary values, we will be using label encoding. We will be using label encoding. Readily available library, that is SKLearn, Scikit-learn. We know that Scikit-learn is a readily available library which is having label encoder as its class. By using that, we are converting our data converting the numbers into binary form. And after converting that, we are performing feature scaling. Okay, na? Feature scaling is a standardization technique that which the independent variables present in the data set are getting into fixed range. So the dependent variables, mostly you will do label encoding. We will do label encoding for dependent variables. For independent variables, we will do feature scaling. What is meant by feature scaling? Feature scaling is nothing but getting all values into one fixed range. Getting all values into some fixed range. That is known as feature scaling. There are two feature scaling techniques. See here, guys. There are two feature scaling techniques. One is min-max normalization and second one is standardization. Min-max normalization and second one is standardization. So what is the formula for min-max normalization? As you can see, x nu is equal to xi minus min of x by max of x minus min of x. This is the formula for min-max normalization. If it is for standardization, that is x nu is equal to xi minus x mean by standard deviation. So in our project, we will be using standardization technique, not min-max normalization. So the formula that is being used, if it is standard deviation, is standardization is x nu is equal to xi minus x mean by standard deviation. So feature scaling has been done, and we had get all the independent variables into some fixed range, after we had splitted our data into training data and for testing data, because we need to perform the model construction. That is the reason why I have done the splitting of testing data and training data.